Archery deer hunting is a difficult game. It's even more difficult when you throw in a couple of cameramen and all of their gear. But when archery season opened this year, Tim Lincoln was up for the challenge.
A little patience, it'll work out.
This quest for an archery buck began on the afternoon of the opening day of Arkansas's archery season in late September. But Lincoln started laying the groundwork for this hunt several weeks prior to opening day, luring deer close to his stand with feed and using a game camera to pattern their daily movements.
Same time, we'll go in, change the camera, check the feeder, put a little corn out, leave. And when it comes time to hunt, you just play the same game. You go in, put your corn out, set everything up, and one guy climbs the tree and the other guy drives out. And the deer doesn't know how many people coming or going in the truck.
It didn't take long for the first deer to show up.
Doe, baby, right underneath us. Seeing deer move towards us up this tree line. That's pretty much pattern. We should get him left to right here in front of us.
Got in the tree and, like I say, 10, 15 minutes, first deer under us, and got a real good view from up there. Obviously, we can see, you know, probably 120 acres total.
Deer were all over the place. For the next 3 hours, dozens of deer trickled through the field behind the stand. Many were does, but several good bucks also slowly worked their way through the tall grass in the distance.
I think we saw, 50 deer that day, maybe. It was awesome. I mean, you can go anywhere, anytime, anywhere. You can go and sit for 3 hours and film 50 deer. You're in the right spot.
But getting a buck in precisely the right spot is another story, especially when the automatic feeder goes off at the most inopportune time. And that wasn't the only close call.
There's an A point right there. If he gives us a shot, we're going to shoot him.
You got to be patient. You know, I bow hunt all year. I don't gun hunt at all. So I've got all year and plenty of time to get him right. And, you know, it's just, if it's not right, you just shouldn't take the shot.
Steady wind from an unfavorable direction and frequent gusts certainly didn't help.
The wind definitely wasn't in our favor that day. Several deer did try to come in, and they did wind one of us. We'd filmed so many deer that day and looked at a lot of really, really nice bucks, and I knew we had another chance or two at it, so we were just patient, and it was a great day in the woods. Even, you know, it's not always about killing the deer when you go hunting, just being able to be there and see it, and to me, there's nothing better.
Except, perhaps, sticking a buck on camera. 4 days later, Lincoln returned to the stand to try to close the deal.
The first deer that we saw when we got in the stand that day is one that we've been watching on the cameras. Phenomenal deer.
But another buck was the first to show up under the stand.
Come on in here.
And once again, Mother Nature intervened.
I think the steady wind was way more in our favor that day, but it was starting to change. I think we had some weather developing, so we were getting an occasional gust going the other way.
But as light began to fade, so did the wind, and a group of several does and two bucks cautiously approached the feeder.
We whispered about him a little bit and went back and forth and looked at the sunlight and pretty much decided, you know, even though there were 10 or 12 other deer right there in the frame, he was going to be our guy.
much too high. Coming. Decent deer though.
You work a little bit, a few weeks, and get them on a string and do what you're supposed to do, and they kind of do what they do. Great feeling when you can, you know, get it the way you wanted it, and especially the camera in the tree, and I was happy with it. You know, it worked out.